It's Monday night, so it's our PacCast game of the week. Tonight we're live from the MAC on the campus of Monmouth University in West Long Branch as the Red Flash of St. Francis, Pennsylvania take on the hometown Hawks of Monmouth.
Monmouth trying to change that with this young sophomore-driven team. Here's a three on the way, and it is good for Alexis Canady. Canady with all kinds of problems. She'll fire the three and hit. Another one for Alexis Canady. Gibbs able to get past Womack and pull up from the right baseline. Canady gets it ahead for Womack. Nobody going to touch Womack. Goes left side with a layup.
With Leach and Canady.
Lilly turns around, goes glass and gets it. That is a pretty, pretty move from Brittany Lilly, who's got 9 points in the half. This turnaround for St. Francis, PA, as they were trailing 20-12 at one point and then go on a 15-4 run to close out the half and take the three-point advantage. Let's get a little bit inside information from our Craig D'Amico.
All right, thanks, Matt. We're here with St. Francis head coach Susan Robinson-Fruchtel, and coach, you have the lead at halftime there. Things seem to settle down a little bit from a fast-paced first half of that half.
Yeah, well, we didn't hit shots early, and you know, we talked about that. We didn't do that Saturday, and I thought we let our shooting dictate our defense. Tonight we dug in. You know, they got the lead. We dug in, played some good defense down the stretch of that first half, and got the lead back, so I'm pretty happy right now. It's a tough game.
Now, they've done a good job of shutting down Leach a little bit, but Lily's emerging here in the first half.
Well, I think, honestly, our team will go how Brittany Lilly goes. Not in just this game, but in every game. She controls the floor. It's not really her scoring, but if she makes great decisions, we'll play well for the most part. And I thought that last 10 minutes of the half, she made some pretty good decisions.
Now, obviously, a big game for you guys in the standings. Magic numbers 2 to clinch the regular season championship. What's the message at halftime?
Well, it's a really player desperation at this time of the year because you're getting really close to March where it's win or go home. And we need to play with desperation in order to try to get this number one seed.
Coach, best of luck in the second half. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Coach, I would imagine it's not that difficult to get your team up to play the number one team in the Northeast Conference. What were some of your thoughts about the way the game started tonight?
I mean, I thought we did some really nice things in stretches. But again, if you hit the stretch run, you got to make foul shots and you got to make good decisions. And right now, I think we're doing a really good job defensively overall. But, you know, if you're going to win a championship, you got to make foul shots and you got to make good decisions on offense. And right now, that's where we struggled in the first half.
What are your thoughts on the Rooney-Leach matchup? You told us that might be one to watch. How's that working out for you so far?
I think that they really have kind of blanked each other out, so to speak. I think they're both doing a terrific job and doing the things that they're capable of doing.
Now, what was the message to the team in the locker room at halftime? Any adjustments to look out for?
No, just watch the defense. Don't make up your mind what's open. I mean, out of our 8 turnovers, 7 were off for steals, and they haven't pressed. They're just not making good decisions offensively.
All right, Coach, best of luck in the second half.
Smith from the top of the key gives to Daly around the
screen. Good offense from the Red Flash. Oh, nice inside-out play.
Quick three from Canady from the outside, and she hits. That's her third three of the night. She's got 9. Womack for Canady.
Look at the floor spacing from Monmouth. Very nicely done here.
Bratis will pull up. Nice, sweet jumper for Gina Bratis. Downtown, off the mark, and Rooney grabs the defensive board. Monmouth looking to run with a 3-on-3. Womack on the baseline, goes glass, and gets it.
Great pass.
Beautiful feed inside. Rooney, Martin, and easy two. Monmouth gets the offense going. Here's a steal by Thorne. A lot of red jerseys running the floor. It's Daly from the left side. The layup up and in. Smith working hard to get it up court against Allen. There's Williams. Good spot for her, but unable to get it. Great sneak in to get the offensive rebound and the putback for Allison Daly. Canady's open from the outside, and she will hit. 4th three-pointer of the night for Alexis Canady.
Continuity on the floor with the group.
Here's a steal by Rooney. Steps into the passing lane. Left side layup up and in. Rooney with the feed down to Martin. Going up over the top. Goes glass and gets it. All the games in the league this year at the higher seed. Martin down low. The easy finish. And she's got a baker's dozen with 13. On the clock out with the dribble. And Monmouth will win a huge game.
Let me start with you. You held this St. Francis team, the top offensive team in the league. They averaged something like 69 points per game. Well below their average. You forced a bunch of turnovers. What was behind the defensive effort tonight?
you know, we told the kids that they haven't won a game when they're held under 60. So that was our goal. So we do a lot of the conversations in our locker room are not about go beat PA. It's about win the battles to win the war. So we told the kids our goal was to keep under 60. Our goal was number 11, not to have her average. And these kids take great pride in their defense. We're defined by our defense.
Now, right now with this win, you move to within a game of first place, and you control your own destiny for the second seed going into the final weekend. What are your thoughts on where you stand right now going into the final week?
You know, I'm excited. I'm excited for the kids because we hit a point, you know, a couple weekends ago where we had to find ourselves, and I think the kids did a great job of coming out of that stretch, and I think we're playing our best basketball at the right time.
Now, what does it say about this team beating St. Francis, Pennsylvania twice, the defending champions? You're the only team to go up there and beat them in their gym all year. So if you see these guys again somewhere down the road, what does it say about your team?
Well, I think our kids know we can win the game. The problem is the one they beat us last time was the important one in the conference tournament. So we know how important it is. We know how good of a team we are on our home court. And we knew that we had to take care of protecting our home court.
Now, last year, that was more of a young team, a little bit more experienced that year. Do you think that experience will pay off?
Oh, without a doubt. I think our kids didn't really understand what the conference tournament was because we had so many new kids. So I think this year they absolutely understand.
Coach, thank you very much and best of luck.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's turn to talk with our player of the game, Alexis Canady. 14 points tonight. Congratulations. What were you seeing out there being able to score so well against them tonight?
It was kind of just extra shooting that we do every day in practice. It's like we don't have time in practice to do extra shooting, so I come in and work out with my coaches, and they motivate me to keep shooting, even though the past couple of games I haven't been shooting very well. So today I was really happy that my teammates found me and that I shot well.
Talk a little bit about the makeup of this team. I was just talking with Coach, you know, more experienced than last year this time. So your team has to be feeling very excited going here into the final week and then beyond into the tournament.
Yes, we're definitely really excited. That was a great win for us, and it shows us that we can beat anybody in this conference as long as we stay together and play as a team.
This win moves you to within a game of first, control your own destiny for second place in the conference. Now, your birthday is coming up real soon in March, the day before the quarterfinals to be exact, so I assume you'd much rather be at home to celebrate rather than on a bus somewhere.
Having mixed emotions about that because I turned 21 this year, but you know, I'd rather be in playoffs than be at home celebrating my birthday because it's just like everything I work for and everything I've worked for since then, everything our team has worked for, it's just like the biggest birthday present we could give each other, or they could give me, is just for us to win.
Congratulations and best of luck down the road.
Thank you.
All right, Matt, the Monmouth Hawks are one win away from their fifth 20-win season, victorious over the defending champions here in West Long Branch tonight.